Good morning to everyone that's listening to this broadcast today. I appreciate you so much, and God bless you today. This is a wonderful day today. There's a lot of things going on in our world all around us. I like the song, "This is the day that the Lord has made. I'm going to rejoice and be glad in it." And I want to encourage you today to rejoice in the Lord. Regardless of what everything is going around, remember that God has everything under control. I was reading in Acts chapter 17, and I was talking about the Apostle Paul was talking to the people on Mars Hill, and he had perceived that they were way too superstitious. And he had to combat this, and he had a difficult time trying to communicate with them. He said in verse 24, God has made the world. And, you know, and all the things therein, sin that he is the Lord of heaven and earth and dwelleth not in the temples made by hands. You know, God is in control of everything. And verse 28 says, it's through him that we live and we move and we have our being, everything that we possess. And it also goes on to say, and also your own poets have said, for we have also his offsprings. He was trying to combat the idolatry, and he said, even your own poets talk about we are his offsprings. And it's through him that we live. You know, every morning that we get up, it is a miracle. Every day that we live and we breathe and we get out, there's so many moving parts to us when we get up in the morning. And we've got to be thankful for everything that God has given us and does for us every day on a daily basis. You know, our life, the scripture tells us we're gloriously and wonderfully made. You know, our DNA can stretch clear around the world. We're quite a creation of God. Our five senses and everything we possess, it's such a blessing to God to be able to speak, to be able to see, and to be able to hear, to be able to taste and smell. It's a blessing of God. You know, it's just wonderful. I was thinking many times this week about how God has created us to be this wonderful creation. And God doesn't create any junk. You need to value yourself too. You don't need to offend yourself in any way, because God has got you in his hand. And believe God, he has made you and he's given you life. And so make the most of it. And God will bless you in the days to come. It's through him that we live. You know, God intended for us to be in this time plan. You know, I don't know where I was 2,000 years ago or 4,000 years ago or even 6,000 years ago. I thought about it, but somehow in God's great plan, I was born in 1942, and I appreciate the life that he has given me. It's through him to live, and I'm thankful that I was given to in my life by parents that loved me and cared for me and took care of me. It's through him that we live. And every breath that we take, everything that we eat, we have to have food to live. We have to have things to exist. One little blood clot can make a difference in your life. And so thank God for every day that you live. And God has given us this time frame. We don't have long on this earth, you know. I believe we're going to leave here pretty soon. I believe Jesus is getting ready to take this church out of here. But I thank God it's through we make the best we can of what we have right now. It's through him that we live and we move. Every time we move and every time we get up out of bed, it's a miracle. And we have our being in the creation of God. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. We are a creation of God, a wonderful creator. And I thank God that he has made the heavens and the earth. And he has given us every breath that we take. Enjoy the moment. You know, every heartbeat is a blessing. The longer we live, it seems like we're going to face eternity at some point. We don't know when that time is going to come. But I just want to admonish you today to take God into your life in the best way you can and enjoy the life you have. Make the best of it. If you're going through a difficult time today, if you're having a difficult time having a job or making a living and a lot of things that are going on in our world today, Just remember, God knows where you're at. He's only one prayer away. All you have to do is just seek Him with your whole heart. If you'll seek Him with your whole heart, you will find Him, and He will bless you in a great way. I hope you have a blessed day, and may the blessings of God be upon you, and may He surround you with His loving care. And God bless you today, and I thank you so much for listening to this broadcast today.